guess the only tune that the field could play was all the dreadful wind and rain.
Huh. Anything you sing may be used as evidence against you.
Well, she was having a good time. And it's kind of weird, right, how she's singing this song about this guy making, well, killed somebody and is making stuff out of her finger bones and her breastplate and made a fiddle out of it, I think she said. And she's all happy and it's funny and stuff. Yeah. Not sure. We're missing an entry. There's another entry about the body. Maybe I can look for throat and find out what she said about the throat. I did write that down. Let's just watch this, though. This is Eve. Haven't heard from her in a while.
Can you imagine?
Yeah, exactly.
I tried to get pregnant, too, but it didn't happen.
Eve couldn't get pregnant.
I slept with so many boys. Men. My body refused. I think my period stopped because hers had. I was prettier. I mean, how could we stay the same now? I felt like Hannah had really fucked things up. Set us down separate paths. We had become different.
Which is dangerous for her. We're fading in and out again. Because she has no identity. She uses Hannah's identity. I'm sure you guys realize this. I'm just vocalizing. Okay, so that's the body. What about the throat? Maybe I could find another entry about how they found the body. We've got a few entries about... Okay, so this is Hannah. Hannah found the body and went to the police.
And his throat. How?
I think Eve did it. In his throat? What? There's something... Well, his throat was cut. But there's something still in it. And this is... Eve.
Like I said before, it was three. Something like that. I walked in. Saw Simon. He was on the floor of the living room. His throat had been cut. There was a lot of blood. Yeah, he was dead.
Right. Is this consecutive though? 12:02 and 3 seconds. Could be.
Her story is that she'd waited for him to come back.
Her story.
She put on my wig, some of my clothes, pretended to be me. They talked. She'd enjoyed being me. He said he wanted to be with me. Then he took out a present. Another mirror.
Another mirror?
Just like the one he'd given her earlier. That unique present. She went crazy, smashed the mirror. They argued, screamed. He hit her. So she grabbed a piece of the mirror and just swung it round. She cut his throat clean open.
Huh.
She'd only meant to scare him off.
Wow. Well, obviously both of them are going to implicate the other as the murderer. Unless, of course, it is the same person. And they're split personalities. split personalities aren't always aware that there is another personality. They sometimes think it's a completely different person. Anything else about Shy? Okay, this is Hannah.
Yeah, when I was at school. I worked part-time in the front shop. It was sort of an extended family thing. My dad used to work there, my mom worked there before I was born. I took care of paperwork, filing, typing out invoices, that kind of thing. It was a good job for a girl back then. I didn't work a till or anything, though. I was quite shy, so I wouldn't have liked to have worked a till.
Well, let me look at this again.
Yeah? When I was in the front shop, it was sort of an extended family thing. My mom worked there before I was...
Front shop? I'll write it down, what the hell. I still have more things to look for.
No, he was as shy as me. I asked a friend to ask him out for me.
Eve?
We had our first date at the Odeon in North End.
Right, the Odeon.
We went to see Risky Business. I had on my one best dress. Simon paid. He bought me a whisper, and I was worried about getting chocolate on my teeth.
Whisper? I don't know what that is, whisper. Apparently some kind of candy that was sold in the UK. Whisper... Risky Business... Odeon... Oh wait. A few more terms. I'm just eliminating Visa. Cavalier, the car. Ouija board. You've got another thing about the Ouija board.
When beautiful people died, it always felt like it was a sign.
Eve.
You remember Princess Grace? Grace Kelly? She died in a car crash the year before we met Simon. We used a Ouija board to speak to her, and that gave us the power to find him.
What?
That's what we thought then. That people who die tragically leave some kind of magic behind. We used to share dreams. We used to wake up and write them down in our diaries immediately and compare them.
Anything else about Grace Kelly? Nope. Whoops. Dreams. Which one is the one we just watched?
When beautiful people died, it always felt like it was a sign.
I got this one too.
He saw me singing. One of my shows. I knew who he was. He guessed my name from impressing him. Did. I'm not sure. He later told me it was like he was dreaming.
It was like he was dreaming. Okay, I was just wondering how that dreams comes up with that. Front shop. Nope, it's just that. Okay. Then there's the boxes and the cellar. That's the only one on that. Cellar. Okay, we've got more about the cellar. So the box is removed, right? I'm just going to play this to remind everybody and myself.
It was after dinner. I think it was something his mother said. Sad stuff. Boxes in the cellar. Nursery stuff. I suddenly remembered that it was in the wrong place. With a torch and went, pulled them open, saw the body. I screamed and That's when I called the police.
54:39. So this is almost a minute later. More about... what? Boxes? I don't know which one I... Boxes or cellar? Boxes, I think.
The whole thing was wrong. The bags, I think they were from our kitchen, you could probably check that. We never go into the cellar. It's just a place we put things we don't need.
Mm, like a body.
Dad used to grow mushrooms there. The bags were taped up. I think it was parcel tape, but I think it was ours.
Okay, and here's, what's her name? Hannah, from a different day.
Well, fine, considering. I got back into the house today, and that was weird, knowing your people had been there through my things. It's like I'd been burgled. I mean, worse, obviously. I don't know. I haven't lived in the cellar yet. They sent a cleaner in. As good as new, he said. Mm. But they had to throw some stuff out. Couldn't get the blood out. And I'm still waiting to hear from the coroner so we can get a date set for the funeral. It's going to be a cremation. So...
so... and here's Eve.
It happened very quickly. We hardly had to talk to each other. We agreed almost silently. The baby was what mattered. We'd help each other. We cleaned up. We bagged up the broken mirror, her clothes. They're gone. We took him down to the cellar. We had an alibi. And we wanted the body to be found later.
They did it together?
We wanted to have suspicion on us, so we could then disprove it, rather than have it linger. Better to keep the body in the house than risk being seen with it. The watch, that was my touch.
So he confesses here?
To make sure the alibi stuck.
Apparently she confessed that they both did it. But we're not over here. That's the cellar. Boxes, bags.
Then will the police let me back in the house? They let me take a bag of clothes with me, but...
Alright, that's not related to the bags in the cellar. This might be.
Okay. I parked up in the street. It was busy, so I had to park down the end of the road. Walked up, knocked on the door, no answer. I took my keys out of my bag and unlocked the door. The main lock was unlocked. You can tell because the key doesn't turn when you try to turn it to the left. I walked in. Simon's coat wasn't on the peg. I couldn't see his shoes in the shoe rack. I shouted out. I walked straight into the kitchen because he usually sits in there to have a cup of tea and read his paper, but he wasn't there. I touched the kettle, it was cold. I looked quickly in the living room, nothing. So I walked upstairs to the bedroom and he wasn't there. I didn't search for him because it was pretty clear he wasn't there. I had a shower. The phone rang whilst I was in the shower. I didn't answer it. I think it was Eric. Then I was just exhausted. So I lay down on the bed and I fell asleep, though I didn't mean to. I woke up a couple of hours later and I was surprised to see no one in the bed next to me. And then I remembered where I was and what had happened. That's when Eric called again. This time I spoke to him. Then I called Doug and Eleanor. And then I decided to come and see you. Eleanor?
Alright, who's Doug and Eleanor? Those aren't the people that own the bar, are they? Because I threw out that note. I shouldn't throw out anything. Oh, it's not. Never mind. Hold on. Because I put the note somewhere. Let's see. Nope. The people who own the bar are Peter and Susan. So I gotta look them up now. Doug and Eleanor. And... is this... this is a different room. It's the same white shirt. At least it looks like it. Or it's buttoned up more. Yeah, it's many months later, too. Oh, wait. I don't know if this is Eve? Okay. Hannah's the shy one. Maybe she has more buttoned up.
I parked up on the street. It was busy, so I parked down the end of the road. I walked up to the house. I knocked on the door. No answer. I took my keys out of my bag, unlocked the door. The main lock was unlocked. I could tell because the key wouldn't turn when I tried. I couldn't see his shoes on the shoe. He wasn't there. I didn't know. I think it was Eric, his boss. And then I called Simon.
Did we watch that one?
Okay. I parked up in the street. It was busy, so I had to park down the end of the road. Walked up, knocked on the door, no answer. I took my keys out of my bag and unlocked the door. The main lock was unlocked. You can tell because the key doesn't turn when you try to turn it to the left.
These are different days.
Okay. I parked up on the street. It was busy, so I parked down the end of the road. I walked up to the house. I knocked on the door. No answer. I took my keys out of my bag, unlocked the door. The main lock was unlocked. I could tell because the key wouldn't turn when I tried to turn it to the left. I walked in. Simon's coat wasn't on the peg.
Coat not there.
See his shoes on the shoe rack.
Shoes not there.
I shouted out.
Shout out.
I walked straight into the kitchen. He usually sits in there to have a cup of tea and read his paper. He wasn't there. I touched the kettle. It was cold.
I'm just seeing if these match.
Okay. The door. Shoe rack. I walked in. Simon's coat wasn't on the peg.
This is rehearsed.
I couldn't see his shoes in the shoe rack. I shouted out. I walked straight into the kitchen because he usually sits in there to have a cup of tea and read his paper. But he wasn't there. I touched the kettle. It was cold. I looked quickly in the living room. Nothing. So I walked upstairs to the bedroom and he wasn't there.
Living room, then bedroom she went to. Sorry, guys.
Okay. Touched the kettle. It was upstairs to the bedroom. I looked quickly into the living room. Nothing. I walked upstairs to the bedroom. He wasn't there. I didn't search for him because it was pretty clear he wasn't there. Then I had a shower whilst I didn't answer it.
Eric. Then,
so I woke up a couple of hours later and I was surprised to see no one in the... That's when Eric called again. And then I decided to...
Eric and then parents. So apparently this is also Hannah. And this is Hannah. She's just reiterating the story. Okay. They're asking her again.
He wasn't there. In the shower. I didn't answer it. I think it was Eric. Then I was just exhausted. So I lay down on the bed. I woke up a couple of hours later and then I remembered where I was and what had happened. That's when Eric called again. This time I spoke to him. Then I called Doug and Eleanor. And then I decided to come and see you.
Huh.
Eleanor.
In this one, she left out Doug and Eleanor. The blue, this is Hannah. Everyone except for the person in the white shirt is Eve. 7 seconds.
Yeah. I'd be mad at Eleanor's, and they're very worried. I feel sorry for them.
They're obviously a married couple.
I got a job to contribute, you know. Doug knew someone and I got a job as a dinner lady at the primary school. They said it didn't matter if I could cook or not, just don't poison the kids. Uh-huh. So you see, it's always been complicated between me and Simon. It's never just been the two of us. There's always been pressure.
Oh yeah, the third, Eve. Alright, so more about... this is, yeah, Doug. Her friend, I guess?
I hoover, I dust every week. Maybe less. I once asked Eleanor how often I should dust, and she said, if people ask, tell them you do it once a week. But every few weeks it's okay. I think she was just trying to make me feel better. I mean, when I was there, she was hoovering every day. You know, ran an ordered house. You know how that generation is, putting on a brave front. She has secret stashes of cigarettes. Doug doesn't even know she smokes. When I was there, I saw her. She has these sort of porcelain vases, ornamental, next to the Reader's Digest books. Cigarettes inside. And she still has them. I mean, last time I was there, I looked in a vase. There was a fresh pack.
Yeah.
I mean, all those years of marriage, and she still has a secret like that.
Pretty scary, isn't it? Is this the one I just watched? Hold on. Yeah, okay, then... is this the one where she's describing what she did?
Okay.
Yeah.
And then,
so she called Doug and Eleanor, 1546, 1554. This is a little later.
Yeah. 1984. Wasn't awful here in the end. We were living at Doug and Eleanor's. I lost the baby at the end of spring and my parents died in the summer.
Mm.
It was a hot summer, a heat wave. So when they discovered the bodies, it was just awful. Because of the circumstances, them dying together like that, they brought in a lot of police. A forensic entomologist. I had to look that up. It was because of the heat.
Who died? Wait. Who died?
No, it wasn't awful.
1984.
I lost the baby at the end of spring and my parents died.
Oh, her parents. Summer. They found her parents.
Them dying together like that.
How do they die? Parents. Right now, parents. So we're still on Doug, and there's an entry missing, which we might be able to find under Eleanor. Eleanor. Okay, these we've watched. Mention Eleanor. This is a different one. Actually, not completely sure who this is.
I speak with Eleanor at least once a day.
Once a day.
Not that there's anything much to say.
Ooh. Really? Uh-huh. Spill? You spilled it? No. Her drink? This is an ant. I'm just... I want to see what happened after she spilled a drink. Why'd she spill the drink?
No, not drugs. I mean, just
something else.
Drinks, but never very much. He goes to the pub and has one or two. Sometimes we go together. He drinks wine with food, but no, he doesn't have any kind of drinking problem.
Mm. I'll be right back, guys. Okay. Anyway, so I just happened to look up drink just to see if anything else about that spell, but... ...1984 is when her parents died. It's not... ...84. Why would it be spelled out like that? Alright, nothing else. Parents. Let me get the contents of this. Context.
I got pregnant. Had a big powwow in the room. And they decided we should get married.
Alright. More about parents. Is this all the same? Oh, wait. Is this like a scan line? Or is this... that's a scan line. I thought it was like on the wall, but I see it's over here as well. Alright, so... 625, 229, 41, 41, 28, 42. Oh, I'm reading it backwards because the dates are backwards. It's actually 1:41 in the afternoon, blah blah blah. Alright, so they decide to get married.
No. I lost the baby. I had a miscarriage at 8 months.
I want to look that up, miscarriage.
We carried on living at Sam's parents until... but it was only a few months after.
I already had that written down. A miscarriage.
Then my parents died. It was the worst year of my life.
1984.
A miscarriage and then my parents.
Right, she's 17. Which means at the time of this interview, she's 27, because now we're 94. This last one.
Yes. I inherited it from my parents, so it made sense to move back, me and Simon. Felt like going back to old ways.
Alright, back to the old house.
Reminded me of being a girl, the dollhouse in the attic, old things. We didn't sleep in my parents' bedroom for a long time. We decorated it as soon as we moved in, but it was another year before we started sleeping there.
Now, I don't think there's anything else about the dollhouse. I just want to eliminate this before I go on. Well, there is. Oh, wow. And Eve talks about the dollhouse.
Yes. I read a lot as a child and watched lots of TV. Then the doll's house we had, we still have in the attic. It's kind of a fairy castle. We used to play up there and make up our own stories.
Hmm. So what are we looking at? Dollhouse? This is the one we just looked at?
She recognized me from the window. She told me to come inside, and she hid me.
Oh, it's an old one.
In the attic into a place where Hannah could play. It was a dollhouse. She hid me up there. No one else ever went into the attic. It was her place.
Well, you know, it's kind of unrealistic. This is Eve, of course. That they have these two girls who are identical, but they're living across the street from each other. and they would see each other in the window. Duh, you gotta think that they're gonna wonder about why is there someone who looks just like me, right? Alright, some more about this.
I'm not sure where the dollhouse came from. I don't know if it was given to them or they inherited it. And they wouldn't have had the money to buy it. It was so huge. Mm. It must have been taken up to the attic in parts and then reassembled up there.
Sounds pretty elaborate.
It's a beautiful thing. Wallpaper to scale. Little furniture. The lights work.
That's awesome.
Mirrors, beds. Big duvets and pillows. We spent hours and hours playing in it. We invented all these characters and families who lived there. We wrote paperwork from them all. Passports, diaries, and gave them all really elaborate stories.
Interesting.
Once, a moth got trapped in there. We'd left a light on. It was making the most horrendous noise. We tried to kill it, but it was tough.
A moth?
We ended up crushing it under a copy of the Arabian Nights.
How big was this moth? You had to crush it under a giant book? So, that was like their practice for how they did the whole identity thing later on. Right? Well, not so much practice, but it's where they got the idea from. It's like, well, we made up stories and passports and all this stuff. Alright, so continuing.
The legal stuff was completed very quickly. Hand moved back in with Simon. Eric gave Simon the week off to help with the move. He decorated, modernized wallpaper curtains. Hannah insists the attic be left as it was, dollhouse and all. Simon never went up there.
Hmm. So that must have been the one about Eric that we couldn't see. Or one of them anyway. I think there was six, I'm not sure. Now I'm just wondering, I want to look at their fingerprints. Or, you know, something. Take their fingerprints. Because obviously they took their fingerprints, right? How do you fake fingerprints? Alright, so we got a bunch about fingerprints. I not only want to ask her, I want to see these fingerprints.
Fine. I never had my fingerprints taken before. I once put my hand in the oven.
One hand? Because you know what I'm thinking? I'm thinking about the scene in Seven. In case you guys don't know the movie with Brad Pitt, Kevin Spacey, and Morgan Freeman. Gwyneth Paltrow. I don't want to spoil that. It's an awesome movie. It's one of my favorite movies, actually. Really well done. But, the killer, so as not to spoil it to anybody, burned his finger so that he wouldn't leave fingerprints at the crime scenes. So that reminds me of that. But she said on one hand, so fine, we'll take fingerprints from your other hand. Is this the same? This is a different day.
Fingerprints.
Okay, that doesn't say much. She just said fingerprints, that's it. At least this one's 9 seconds.
Yes, yeah. In order to clean them. I changed the sheets too. With the fingerprints in all those places.
Whose fingerprints did they find? Hers or someone else? Eve.
Could they have been my parents' fingerprints? I'm not sure how long they last for, but is that possible?
And this is from another day.
Really? Go on then. Take the cup. Run your fingerprints. They'll match.
Nice. Real nice. Did they run the fingerprints? Did he do it? I'm pretty much out of search terms except for miscarriage. Which we've got a few here. She talked about it here. And this is from another day. This is Hannah.
They gone to bed feeling ill, thinking it was flu or something. The neighbour called me, I had to use my key to let them in. We found them dead in their bed. And they'd been there for days, no one had noticed. Just awful. It was so soon after my miscarriage. The worst year of my life, and I'd been so happy to get married, and after that it was just like, fuck.
Okay, a little bit more.
Yeah. I was infertile. Thought I was. They told me I was infertile after the miscarriage because of complications.
I'm writing that down. That's going to be my next thing. Here's Eve.
Hannah had a miscarriage. This was late in the pregnancy and it left her infertile. Felt like the universe had corrected its course.
She's happy about that.
We were aligned again.
Right.
But Hannah and Simon were still living with his parents. They were married. Simon had a job at the Glaziers now. Derek had given him a full-time position after he left school. And then...
And then?